Good afternoon and welcome to Senior Night, the night we recognize our end of their final year of high school and their last season as West Lauderdale Knight baseball players. As parents, teachers, and coaches, we hope that you have come to realize that life does not come easy. To be the best at anything, it takes hard work and dedication. At West Lauderdale High, you have received the foundation that is needed to succeed in life. We wish you the very best in life. Our first senior, number 23, Brooks Buchanan. Brooks is the son of Wayne and Claire Buchanan and his brother Mason Buchanan. Major awards that Brooks has received during his high school here at West Lauderdale. He's made the all-defensive team in 2016 and during the 13-year-old World Series. His future plans are to attend MCC unless he receives a baseball scholarship in the near future. The memory or highlight for Brooks is hitting a home run in his first at-home bat of his senior year against Neshoba Central. Number 23, Brooks Buchanan. Our next senior, number 18, Matt Etheridge. Matt is the son of Chris and Christy Etheridge. Grandparents are Randy and Tommy Etheridge and Mitzi Persons. Future plans for Matt are to attend MCC for 2 years and then transfer to a four-year college to earn his degree. His major is undecided. A memory or highlight is playing Ultimate Frisbee on Fridays in the fall. Number 18, Matt Etheridge. Our next senior, number 3, Leighton Jenkins. Leighton is the son of Leslie and Jay Jenkins, and his brother Leeds. His major awards are to continue academic career at East Central Community College. He was Mr. Defense in 2020, selected for Mississippi 3A and 4A All-Star Team, Athlete of the Year, State Games 2020, National Honor Society, National Society of High School Scholars, and baseball. His future plans include playing baseball at East Central Community College. A memory or highlight of Leighton is hitting the go-ahead home run against Newton County. Number 3, Leighton Jenkins. Our next senior, number 5, Tanner Parker. Tanner is the son of Ken and Dusty Parker. His siblings are Jackson and Kennedy. Some of the major awards he received is he made the state games of Mississippi junior and senior year. He was considered Mr. Defense as a sophomore and junior year, and Team Mississippi sophomore year, All-State sophomore year. His future plans are to continue his academic and baseball career at Meridian Community College. And one of the memories and highlights of his career here were playing at MGM Park in Biloxi. Number 5, Tanner Parker. Our next senior, number 9, Jake Smith. Jake is the son of Kim Smith and Doug Smith and sister Rachel Smith. His major awards, he was awarded an academic scholarship to MCC and to Mississippi State University. Future plans include attend MCC and Mississippi State University to major in political science and then attend law school. A memory is for Jake, watching the workers at McDonald's do magic in the parking lot on his way to Starkville. Number 9, Jake Smith. Your next Senior, number 33, Mason Willis. Mason is the son of Marcus and Clancy and brother Drew Willis. His major awards are the 4A All-Star Game, 10th grade, he's first team All-District, and made state games in the 10th and 11th grades. His future plans are to continue and play baseball at East Central Community College. One of his memories and highlights are pitching against Biloxi his junior year at MGM Baseball Field in Biloxi. Number 33, Mason Willis. Our next senior is number 10, Cole Wilkerson. Cole's the son of Will Wilkerson and Cookie Wilkerson, his brother Cord Wilkerson and sister Ava. His major awards are making state games in WL Baseball, leading pitching award. His future plans are to continue baseball and academics at East Central Community College. And one of his favorite memories are pitching 8 innings and securing the win versus Brandon High School his junior year. Number 10, Cole Wilkerson. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your 2021 high school seniors.
Good evening and welcome to Jerry Boat in the Field on the campus of West Lauderdale High School in Collinsville, Mississippi, where tonight the West Lauderdale Knights will take on the Leake Central Gators in the final division contest of the year. The Knights have wrapped up, once again, the division title, and they will go into the North State playoffs as the number one seed out of their division.
Teasers, visiting Leake Central Gators and the West Lauderdale Knights. The Gators are led by head coach Jonathan Hardy. And now your starting lineup and batting order for the Leake Central High School Gators. On the mound and pitching, number 2, Deontay Johnson. The catcher, number 17, Austin Smith. At shortstop, number 4, Antonio Luckett. At third base, number 19, Ashton Leggett. In center field, number 18, DeMar Gardner. At first base, number 25, Cameron Fortenberry. In left field, number 10, Kyron Holloway. In right field, number 13, Bravion Harvey. And at second base, number 7, Todd Edmund. The Gators are led by head coach Jonathan Hardy, assisted by Jake Golden and Casey Henderson. The Knights are led by head coach Jason Smith. And now your starting lineup and batting order for the West Lauderdale Knights. Starting at shortstop, number 3, Layton Jenkins. In center field, number 2, Jackson Parker. In left field, number 31, Cade Kennedy. The DH, number 23, Brooks Buchanan. At first base, number 1, Brett Busby. The pitcher, number 33, Mason Willis. At second base, number 17, Braden Epting. The catcher, number 5, Tanner Parker. In right field, number 18, Matt Etheridge. And at third base, number 34, Dylan Brown. The Knights are led by head coach Jason Smith, assisted by Jody Hurst, Dustin Hammerick, and Jamie Brown. And now, if you would, please stand and remove your hats for the invocation and the playing of the National Anthem. Our Father in Heaven, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you, Lord, for these seniors who have gone through 12 years of school and have come to the point in life where it's time to move out and gain more knowledge. We ask you, Lord, to take care of them, keep them safe. Take care of everyone here tonight, Lord. Give them safe travels home. We ask all this in your precious name. Amen.
Well, I hope you enjoyed senior night here at West Lauderdale. The pregame festivities are over, ready to get started. Leake Central comes in with a record of 6-9, having faced West Lauderdale in the first game of the division this year, and West Lauderdale took that win 15-0. West Lauderdale is bringing with them an 11-game win streak into tonight's contest. They've got a standing record of 19-4, having taken an 8-4 victory over New Hope on Saturday, where Brett Busby was the winning pitcher, giving up 3 hits and 1 earned run over 4 innings. Leighton Jenkins got the save. Jackson Parker had a good day, going 3-for-3 with a double and 1 RBI. Matt Etheridge was 2-for-4 with 1 RBI. Tanner Parker and Leighton Jenkins had 2 RBIs apiece in a well-played contest over in Columbus, in New Hope. Big Hoop's got a good club, so that was a good victory for the Knights late in the season. Mason Willis gets the start on the mound. Mason Willis comes in with a 7-1 record, giving up 7 earned runs on the year, striking out 66 in 42 innings with an ERA of 1.157. Like I mentioned before, the Knights have secured the number one seed out of our region, and we will play New Albany in the first round of the playoffs 2 Thursdays from now. I believe that is going to be April 29th for that game against New Albany here at Jerry Boatner Field. Leading off for the Gators will be Deontay Johnson, number 2.
Leading off for the Gators, the pitcher, number 2, Deontay Johnson.
And strike 1, outside corner. 0-1 count to Johnson. Willis starts with the fastball. Another fastball, 0-2's a count. Fouled off. 3 fastballs in a row. And strike 3, breaking ball outside corner. Good placement right there for Mason. So on 4 pitches, Johnson's retired. Looking.
With one out, the batter's the catcher.
Austin
17.
Smith coming up, catcher Austin for Leake Central. The fastball, 0-1. Right down the middle with that pitch. Mason, his last time out, threw a lot of pitches at Kosciuszko. Probably still feeling the effects of that. Pitched a good game at Kosciuszko. We were able to get the win. Strike 2, 1-2. 3 fastballs to Johnson. That one's only well placed on the outside corner. Tanner sets up on the outside half. Just off the plate, 2-2. And a good breaking pitch gets him. So it's 2 up, 2 down, both by strikeouts.
The 2 outs. Your next batter is the shortstop, number 4, Antonio Luckett.
Antonio Luckett comes to the plate, shortstop tonight. Strike 1. It's a good pitch on the outside half, not called. 1-1. Umpire sets up a good bit on the inside part of the plate. Might not give us that outside pitch that often tonight. Good play by Busby at first on the chopper. Down the first base line to retire the sides. in the broadcast this evening. Had a little important matter to take care of down on the field for senior night. We wish all these seniors the best of luck. All of them are going to be successful at life, which is a big part of the West Lauderdale program, not only becoming good baseball players, but also good people. And that's one of the things Coach Smith, Coach Hurst, Coach Hamrick, and Coach Brown try to stress to these young men, is that being a good person is the first and foremost the best thing you want to be. And each one of them are off to a great start. Seniors will have great careers, whatever they decide to do. Layton Jenkins leading off. Layton hits a drive in the left field corner. And it's misplayed by the left fielder. Jenkins will pull up into second with what could be scored either way. On senior night, we're going to call it a double. So Jenkins will lead off double. Jackson Parker coming up. Jackson Parker has been swinging a really good bat. I think he's 6 for his last 8. A couple of great games in a row. Jackson had a great game at New Hope. Another fly ball out to left field. Left fielder settles under it and makes the catch. So one pitch, one out. Jenkins tags and goes to third. Throw comes back into second.
With one out, the batter's left fielder, number 31, Kate Kennedy.
Kate Kennedy, left fielder coming up. One out in the inning. Knights with a runner on second base after Jenkins doubled in the left field line and Parker's fly out. Move Jenkins to third. Kate gets out ahead of that, fouls it deep off to the left. Fouled out of play. Ball 0 and in, 1 and 1. Kay's moved up in the box a little bit. Pitcher's around 60, 65 miles an hour, so not a lot of velocity there. Low, 2 and 1. And actually, that may be a big adjustment for the Knights hitters. Been used to facing 80 to 85. All year, so it takes a little bit of an adjustment to get used to that speed differential. Cade hammers one off the screen on the third base dugout. Line drive. And 2-2 count. It hits another one. Leighton with an acrobatic move to stay out of the way of that. They just having a little trouble waiting on that. Got to wait a long time. It's one of those pitchers where you actually want to just work up the middle or even the right field with it. You can wait till it gets almost on top of you before you swing at it. And Kay, that base hit up the middle for Kennedy. He did just that. Waited till it got to him. Poked the ball right up the middle for a base hit. So Jenkins will come in to score and single by Kennedy, and that'll make it 1-0 Knights. Brooks Buchanan coming to the plate.
Your next batter is DH number 23, Brooks Buchanan.
Brooks hurt his thumb Friday night, playing with an injured thumb. If they had it looked at, I don't believe it's broken, but it certainly is swollen. And Brooks hits a ball out into right field that's going to fall in front of the right fielder. So Buchanan comes up, injured or not. That was a good swing by Brooks. Drops the ball into right field for a single. So now the Knights have runners on first and second. One out. Leading the game 1-0.
First baseman number one, Brett Busby.
Brett Busby coming to the plate, playing first tonight. Pick over to first, not close. Mm-hmm. It's a ball outside to Busby. Throw over, not close. Brooks gets back in plenty of time. Busby comes in hitting .431 on the year. Two home runs, 23 RBIs. Britt's had a good year, both on the mound and at the plate. And 2-0 count. Ball in the dirt. Runners will advance 90 feet. Now the Knights have runners on second and third. Busby ahead in the count 3-0. And that's ball four. Load them up. So on four straight pitches, Busby takes first. Mason Willis coming to the plate. Mason Willis hitting .277 on the year. A couple of home runs, 16 RBIs, six doubles.
Mason Willis.
Bases loaded right here. Be a good chance to have a few RBIs. He fouls it off. Fouls it straight back off the screen. Ball in the dirt, 1-1. One out in the inning, bases loaded. Knights already up 1-0. Ball outside, 2-1. All inside, 3-1. Runners don't advance. I don't know. Kay just didn't think he had time to get there. Ball got away from the catcher. 3-1 count. Probably no use in trying that. Pitcher's having trouble throwing strikes. And that's ball four. That'll walk in a run. The score moved to 2-0 Knights. As Willis draws a 5-pitch walk. Goes to touch first. It'll be replaced by courtesy runner Wyatt Castle.
Courtesy runner for the pitcher, number 7, Wyatt Castle. Your next batter is the second baseman, number 17, Braden Epting.
Braden Epting will be the hitter, hitting .292 on the year. Braden's got 7 doubles, 1 home run, 16 RBIs in the season. Second baseman for the Knights. Good chance to bring in some runs here if he can get something to get his bat on it. Bases loaded. That'll hit him. That'll bring one in. That'll be 3-0 Knights. And Tanner Parker will come to the plate.
The catcher, number 5.
Tanner Parker, the catcher for West Lauderdale. So Tanner Parker, Mason Willis, and Leighton Jenkins were selected to play in the Crossroads, the Mississippi Coaches Crossroad Classic over in the Mississippi College. They're selected on the 3A, 4A team, which is an honor. That's an all-star team statewide. They have their choice to represent the north half over there should they choose to do so. I know they have conflicts with the schedule of the game due to senior trips and things that happen after your senior year is over, so we'll wait and see what they decide to do. But it's an honor just to be selected for that team. So congratulations to those three. Count to Parker, bases loaded, and that'll be ball four. Knights once again a walker run in. Visit the mound from the Leake Central coach. Needless to say, moves from center field to the mound, and the hitter for West Lauderdale will be Matt Etheridge, right fielder. Matt Etheridge hitting 333 on the year.
Number
Ball outside, 1-0. Matt Swings fouls it off, right-hand side, 1-1. Still one out in the inning. Still the bases are loaded with Knights. Four runs already home on three hits. Matt fouls it off again, right-hand side. 1-2 count. He's waiting as possibly long as he can for that ball to get there. Just not a lot of velocity on the mound for the Gators tonight. Matt, it's a soft ground ball to the shortstop. He's going to try to make the play. It's not going to make it in time. Throws it away. Knights will score two. Etheridge will stay on first. Parker will advance from second to third. And that'll make the score 6-0 Knights. On senior night, we might call that a hit too. I'm not sure he would have thrown him if he fielded it cleanly and made a good throw. Not sure he would have got it out. Back to the top of the lineup, Leighton Jenkins, Etheridge on first. Tanner Parker on third. Called strike on the outside half. There goes Etheridge, takes second base, uncontested. Be a stolen base for Matt. One and one count on Jenkins. One and two count on Jenkins. I'm not sure about those calls. The umpire probably needs to call that both ways. He's going to call that pitch. He didn't call it in the top half for us. I'm calling it now. I know the League Central may have trouble throwing strikes, but call that both ways. We can speed this game along. Parker comes in on the wild pitch. We make it 7-0 Knights. And a 2-2 count to Jenkins, one out. Etheridge stands at third base. And Leighton swings and misses. So that'll be out number two. On a strikeout, Leighton Jenkins. Jackson Parker come up. Two outs in the inning. Ball outside, 1-0. Jackson Parker hits it to first. First baseman kicks it. And I don't know what Jackson was thinking right there. Made a turn, went to second, got thrown out, got the run home. 8-0. Kind of has a feel of a backyard wiffle ball game right now, to be honest with you. Thank you.
and nobody left on base. You up for the Gators, Ashton Leggett, DeMar Gardner, and Cameron Fortenberry.
First baseman for Leake Central leading off, Ashton Leggett. Mason Willis back on the mound. And strike one. Fastball right down center cut. Fastball inside half, swung and missed, 0-2. Curveball chopped out in the middle of play. Let it roll foul, and they do. That'll bring him back to first. Excuse me, bring him back to the home plate. Make him finish his at bat. It's a good job right there. Knights had no chance to throw out Leggett. Decided to let it go foul. Tanner Parker touched it as soon as it got there. Exactly what you want to do. Ball up, 1-2 count. That's strike three, outside corner. Pitcher DeMar Gardner coming to the plate for Leake Central. One out in the inning. Fastball, 0-1. Swing and a miss on a high fastball, 1-2. And that's fastball number three. Another strikeout. So that's two up, two down in the inning, both by strikeouts.
The two outs, the first baseman, number 25, Cameron Fortenberry.
Cameron Fortenberry, first baseman, striding to the plate. Ball up, 1-0. Inside, fouled off, 1-1. Outside, 2-1. Fastball threw it past him, 2-2. And strike three on the breaking pitch. Tags him, runner out. And so that'll do it for the top half of the second for the League Central Gators. No runs on no hits. No errors committed by the Knights. Through 1.5. The score is 8-0 West Lauderdale.
And that half the inning for the Gators. There were no runs, no hits, no errors, and nobody left on base. View up for the Knights, Cade Kennedy, Brooke Buchanan, and Brett Busby. The Gators return to action Thursday night when they host Kemper County. The game is 6 p.m.
Kate Kennedy to lead off for the Knights. Bottom half of the second. Kennedy 1-for-1, his last time up, single to center. Drove in one RBI with that single. It's a ball up, 1-0. Kate, it's a high fly ball out the left field. It's going to stay in play, left fielder under it, and makes a catch in foul territory for one away. So Kate Kennedy flies out in foul territory for the first out, the bottom half of the second for the Knights. Brooks Buchanan coming to the plate. Brooks singled his last time up, scored a run.
With one out, the bat is the DH, number 23, Brooks Buchanan.
Brooks in the DH hole tonight due to his thumb injury. Normally plays center. Jackson Parker's holding that down for him. Brooks hits a line drive right over the shortstop's head. It's going to roll to the fence. Buchanan's going to get two. Center fielder doesn't appear to be in a real hurry to pick it up. Brooks is going to try for three. And he's in there safely. Brooks has got good speed. And so that'll be a triple for Buchanan. Brett Busby coming to the plate. Busby walked his last time up.
Your next batter is first baseman number 1, Brett Busby.
Ball outside, 1-0. Two and oh. Brett fouls it back. 2-1. One out in the inning. Buchanan stands at third base. Score 8-0 Knights. And ball outside, 3-1. Really pretty much all fastballs from DeMar Gardner. Haven't seen really anything off speed at all. That's in the dirt. That'll be ball four to Brett. That'll bring Mason Willis to the plate. And overthrow of the pitcher will cause Buchanan to come home. Nobody standing on second, so Brett Busby takes second base. That'll make score 9-0 Knights. You really get the feeling that the Gators may not want to compete tonight. Mason Willis is a fly ball out to right field. Right fielder's under it. Can't make the play. It's over his head. Mason will pull into second with what very well could be a double since the right fielder didn't touch it. On senior night, I'm sure that's what it'll be. Wyatt Castle will courtesy run for Mason Willis.
Courtesy run for the pitcher, number 7, Wyatt Castle.
Braden Epstein coming to the plate. Braden Epstein was hit by a pitch his last at bat.
The batter is the second baseman, number 17, Braden Epstein.
Ball high. Runners don't advance. On the wild pitch from Gardner. It's going to be a visit from the mound. Visit to the mound from the Gator coach. It's going to be another pitching change. Looks like number 17, Austin Smith, will be the pitcher for League Central. He throws it pretty well. Seems like this may have been the pitcher we faced in the first game we played against them at League Central at the beginning of the season. Moving from shortstop to catcher. Lee Antonio Luckett. Brady Neptune's got a 1-0 count on him, striding back into the plate. A 2-0 count. A little bit more velocity from Smith. Ball inside, 3-0. And that hit Braden. Second time he's been hit tonight. He'll go to first, load him up on the hit by pitch. Tanner Parker will come to the plate. Still one out in the inning. Bases loaded by the Knights.
Your next batter, number 5, the catcher, Tanner Parker.
It's all speed pitch from Smith. High, 1-0. Again, high 2-0. Fastball. High and out of the zone. So the Knights have Epstein at first. Wyatt Castle courtesy running for Mason Willis at second. Tanner Parker hits a drive down the left field line. Is it going to stay fair? No, it hooks foul up the fence. Right off the Medical Arts Surgical Group sign in left field. Just foul. So it's a 2-1 count. White Castle stands at second. Brett Busby stands at third. Epstein at first. Good curveball from Smith. Calls Tanner to pop it up. It's in fair play. Parker didn't run out the pop fly. That's probably infield by rule on that. So now we got two outs. Base is still loaded. Matt Etheridge at the plate. Etheridge singled his last time up, drove in two RBIs, one for one on the night, scored a run. Gets behind in the count, 0-1. Swings and misses, curveball in the dirt, 0-2. Another curveball, high chopper. It's going to be tough to get Etheridge. He runs well. There's a pass ball at first. The runners are going to stay where they're at. So, what probably will be an infield single. You wouldn't have got him with a good throw. Still going to be bases loaded. The score moved to 10-0 Knights. Flip the order to the top of the order, Leighton Jenkins.
Shortstop number 3, Leighton Jenkins.
Leighton's coming into the game hitting 338. Ball high. Three home runs on the year. 17 RBIs. And that plunked Leighton. That'll force a run in. Eleven to nothing, Knights. And Cole Wilkerson's going to get in at bat. So Cole Wilkerson on senior night is going to get his first at bat of the year. He's one of the primary pitchers, of course. He threw a perfect game against League Central early in the year. Left-handed hurler, signed with East Central Community College. So he's going to get a crack at it. Now I would imagine if Cole gets a hit, this is going to turn into a, it's going to get loud, Jerry Boat in the field. Takes a curveball strike. Crowd doesn't like it. They want everything to go Cole's way tonight for sure. And ball outside, 1-1. Ball low, 2-1. Three and one, runners will hold. And Gary hits it up the middle, and it gets through. Cole, Gary Wilkerson. So Cole gets his first hit of the year on a single up the middle. And everybody loves that. So Cole may very well end the year batting 1,000. Cade Kennedy's up. Cade hits a fly ball to center field. Center fielder ranges over. Can make the play. Runners will move up 90 feet. Score one run. Still nobody out. Bottom of the second. In all honesty, this is fun for senior night. Does very little to prepare the Knights for the playoffs that are coming, but it is a district game. We have to complete it. It was a good pitch. Right on the outside corner. 0-1 to Buchanan. It was the best pitch Smith's thrown. Another curveball. That's in there. 0-2 count. One out in the inning. Base is still loaded. Brooks taps it foul. Swinging strike. Strike out of Buchanan. Ends the inning. But at the end of two, scores 13-0 Knights.
Holiday, Gravion Harvey, and Todd L. Edmonds. one, Jake Smith.
Senior Jake Smith to make his appearance out of the pen. I think Jake's only other appearance was against Clinton at the Stringer Tournament earlier this year. So it's good to see Jake get some work here in a varsity game on senior night. Entering the game at second base will be Drew Willis. I'm happy to see Drew in the game. He's a sophomore playing with his brother Mason at first. I think that's the first time they've been on the field together in both of their high school careers. Is Mason a senior, Drew a sophomore. Tyron Holloway comes to the plate for the Gators. And Jake Smith delivers his pitch. Ball outside. Ball two outside. It's ball three. 3-0 count. 3-0 count to Holloway. Holloway the left fielder. That's ball four.
You got it, Jake.
Your next batter, number 13, Bravion Harvey.
Bravion Harvey coming up to the plate, number 13. For the League Central Gators. That ends the line on Mason Willis for the night. Pitched two innings, struck out five, giving up no hits, no runs. Ball 0, 1-0. Ball 2, 2-0. There's a strike, 2-1. Jake gets one over the plate, 2-1 count. Maybe you'll find a rhythm here, throw a few strikes. Senior night. Be nice to see Jake finish well. Jake seems to be saying he's done. I don't know if something's wrong, don't know the answer. Freshman Ian Harrington will come to the mound. This will be Ian's first varsity action of the year. Ian's pitched well in junior varsity. He's doing a good job. Had him warming up in the bullpen against New Hope Saturday. Just in case, we're able to close that game out with Leighton Jenkins on the mound getting the save. And a good 8-4 win against New Hope.
Number 8, Ian Harris.
So Ian Harrington getting his first varsity action. Tall ninth grader. Throw down. Runner takes second on stolen base. 3-2 count to the hitter. Strike three. And runner's thrown out at third. So that's a double play right there for the Knights. Strike him out, throw him out. Good throw by Tanner Parker. Had plenty of time to get him. Mason Willis being taken out of the game. Leeds Jenkins the winner at first base. So now we have Leighton and Leeds on the same field. That's the late Leeds Jenkins is the brother of Leighton Jenkins, the shortstop. So we've got freshman Leeds Jenkins on the field with Leighton. That's good to see. Ball inside. Ball inside, 2-0, two fastballs from in. Ball in the dirt, 3-0. It's a good game for Ian to get his first varsity action in. Game's out of reach. He can relax, doesn't have to be too nervous. There's a good follow-up 3-0 pitch for 3-1. Strike two, swing and a miss. And Ian strikes him out. To get out of the inning to give him up no runs, good job from Harrington.
to lead off of the night's number one, Brett Busby.
So the Gators make another pitch and change. On the mound will be number 19, Ashton Liggett. And Brett Busby will come to the plate for the Knights. Busby's 0 for 0 on the night with two base on balls. The ball high. 1-0. Scores 13-0 Knights. Bottom of the third. Brett fouls one off the right hand side, 1-1.
Please return a foul ball to third base dugout.
And that's going to hit him. So I believe that's the third hit batter tonight. Now, League Central, Brett Busby will take his base. Mason Willis will come to the plate. Mason Willis doubled down the right field line his last time up. So that's actually the fourth hit batter tonight. Ray Neptune's been hit twice. Leighton Jenkins once, and now Brett Busby once. Ball inside. Brett will stay at first. Ball up, 2-0. Ball up, 3-0. Mason Willis has a drive to center. That's way back. And that is over the windscreen in center field. That ball was a mammoth shot. That's the first one we've seen this year go over the windscreen. That was hit really well by Mason Willis. And on senior night, I'm sure that feels great to him. He knew that was gone the moment it left the bat. That two-run blast will move the score to 15-0. And League Central may have had all they want this evening. And I think that's going to do it, as League Central says they've had enough, and we'll take it to the house, so to speak. So it ends on that. The final score will be 15-0, West Lauderdale Knights. West Lauderdale run their record to 20-4 with that win and increase their win streak to 12 games straight. West Lauderdale have a much tougher test tomorrow where they travel north to 5A Neshoba Central, a team that West Lauderdale defeated earlier in the year, first or second game of the season, if I remember correctly. I think Neshoba Central is a division champ in their district, so it'll be a good matchup tomorrow night. So for Marcus Willis and West Lauderdale Knights Baseball, we'll sign off tonight and see you at the next home game, which will be next Monday against Newton County. Thank you very much.